सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द एक्चुअल बी सी आर सी डायग्राम. एक्चुअल बी सी आर सी एक्चुअली द बी सी आर सी दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टिल नाउ दैट वॉज थ्योरेटिकल साइकिल. इन एक्चुअल प्रैक्टिस देर आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ लॉसेज दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन इट्स ऑपरेशन. ओके, दीज आर लॉसेज और गेन्स दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन द टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस बिटवीन द रेफ्रिजरेंट एंड द सराउंडिंग्स and due to the compression which will not be isentropic but it will be polytropic and also due to the friction and heat transfer occurring in those cycles. Okay, so I have noted down here various types of losses that are occurring and we will discuss each of them one by one. And correspondingly I have drawn the TS diagram over here and I would be drawing the PH diagram along hand so that you understand the process better. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so now let us look into this diagram. You can see that we would start from this point 1D. From point 1D to 1C, what is occurring? It is the superheating in the evaporator of the vapor. That means in the evaporator itself, the state that we actually write is not only the saturated vapor but some superheating is also occurring in the evaporator. So from 1D to this 1C point, we are having what? Superheating in the evaporator only. Okay, now from this point 1C to 1B, what is occurring? The heat gain from the surroundings, because the evaporator temperature is very low and the outside temperature is higher than the evaporator temperature. You can visualize it that the evaporator temperature is around, let us say, minus 5 degrees Celsius for cooling purposes, and outside temperature, let us say, it is 25 degrees Celsius. So naturally the heat will flow from outside to the evaporator line or evaporator suction line. Okay, so suction line is means that refrigerant is going to the compressor. So from 1C to 1B, from 1C to 1B, what is happening from 1C to 1B? The heat is coming from the surroundings. Okay, and superheating is occurring. Okay, superheating is happening over here. And from 1B to 1A, 1B to 1A, this region, this is the pressure drop in the suction line of the compressor, because we are supplying the refrigerant from evaporator to the compressor. So there also the pressure drop is occurring from 1B to 1A. Okay, and from 1A to 1, there is a pressure drop due to the Baer drawing at the compressor suction valve. Now what is this Baer drawing? Actually what happens in the compressor, at the inlet of the compressor, there occurs a sudden change in the dia of the pipeline. Okay, now due to this sudden change, there occurs a losses in the pressure. That is actually part of fluid mechanics. You have incurred that sudden contraction or sudden expansion results in the loss of pressure. So that is what happening here from point 1A to 1. Okay, so now let us represent these four losses onto the pH diagram. Okay, so let me take a separate paper from that. Okay, so I am making this pH diagram on this. Okay, so let us see, this is our pH curve and this is our dome. So I told you that from point 1D to 1A, 1D to 1C, we were having superheating and the heat gain, but there was no pressure change. Okay, so this is point 1D and this is point 1C. Okay, and also from 1C, this is point 1B, sorry, this is point 1C. Okay, and from 1B, what happened? There was a pressure drop in the suction line. So we come to this point 1A, and after that, there was a pressure drop due to the Baer drawing in the compressor inlet. Okay, so we come over here. So this is the constant pressure first, this is the later pressure. So there is a pressure drop. Okay. Now from this, what will happen? The compression process will start, and what it will be? It will not be isentropic anymore. It will be polytropic. Okay. So for the polytropic process, let us draw it. This is the polytropic process, and we reach some point that is 2. This is the 2 point over here. Now let us discuss in this diagram. In this case, we were at 0.1. Now from 1, the polytropic compression will take place. This is the polytropic compression that is taking place, and we reach to the point 2. Now this 2 point, what is this 2 point? This is the outlet of the compressor. Now there are some losses occurring over here also. What are those losses? Let us discuss. Okay, now from 2, now from 2 to 2A, we are having pressure drop at the compressor discharge valve. This means pressure drop at the outlet of the compressor. Okay, pressure drop at the outlet of the compressor is occurring from 2 to 2A, and from 2A to 2B, this is also the pressure drop that is occurring due to the pressure drop in the delivery line, that is in the pipes, because there would be pipes that would be circulating the refrigerant. So from 2 to 2A, we are having the pressure drop in the compressor discharge valve, and from 2A to 2B, we are having the pressure drop in the delivery line or the pipeline. Okay, and one thing also note that in this TS diagram, the constant pressure lines are drawn somewhat like this. Okay, like this. So you can see very well that from this pressure, it has shifted to this pressure. That means the pressure has decreased. So this is how the representation done on the TS diagram. Now we move to the pH diagram again. Okay, we are at this point 2, and from 1 to 2 the process was polytropic with friction involved in that. Now from 2 to 2A, what is there? There occurs a drop in pressure. Why? Because this is at the discharge of the compressor. Okay, so 2 to 2A is the at the discharge of compressor. Now the pressure drop is occurring from 2A to 2B in the delivery line. Okay, in the delivery line. Okay, now we have reached the pressure point 2B. Now from 2B, what we will do? Now we are going to through the condenser process. Okay, so from 2B to 2C, there occurs the heat loss to the surroundings and also the de-superheating of the vapor in the delivery line. Okay, from 2B to 2C, this is the de-superheating. That means that the temperature here, let us say it is around 50 degrees Celsius at 2B, and the outside temperature I have told you 25 degrees Celsius. So that means the heat loss now will take from this refrigerant to the outside or the surroundings. Okay, so that occurs from 2B to 2C. Okay, and from 2C to 3, to this point, there is the pressure drop in the condenser. That means the pressure drops in the condenser is taking place from 2C to 3 point. Okay, and from point 3 to this 3A, we are having subcooling of the liquid in the condenser of the subcooler. That means from 3 to 3A, we are subcooling the refrigerant. Okay, now from 3A to 3B, what is happening? Heat gain in the liquid line. That means the surroundings supply the heat to the refrigerant, because this temperature now is below the surrounding temperature. So here the heat transfer is taking place from 3A to 3B. Okay, now let us represent this same process on the pH diagram. Okay, so now on the pH diagram, what will happen? We have reached the point 2B. Okay, 2B was what? 2B is the pressure drop. This is the maximum temperature reached in the superheated region. Now we would have a heat loss from 2B to 2C, and this heat loss will be in the surroundings in the pipelines. Okay, now from 2C to 3, we would be having pressure drop in the condenser. Okay, so let us say it is somewhat like this, 2C to 3, and from 3 to 3A, what we would be having? We would be having the subcooling, that is decreasing the enthalpy content, that is 3A. And from 3A to 3B, what we would be having? The heat gain from the surroundings. Okay, heat gain from the surroundings. So now we have reached this point 3B. Now what will happen from 3B? From 3B, we would be throttling. So the throttling process, isoenthalpic process, is represented like this. Let us say it comes over here. So it is comes over here. Now from point 4, what is happening? there is also the pressure loss in the evaporator, so it joins over here. Let this point is 4 and this point is 1D. This point is 1D. So this is also showing us the pressure drop, okay, in the evaporator. In this case also we were at 0.3B and then we have throttled it to 0.4, and in the evaporator the losses are occurring from in the pressure from 4 to 1D. Okay, so now I have written all the pressure changes that are occurring and all the heat losses that are occurring on the single page, so you can take a screenshot of this and for further reference, and also you can take the screenshot of this diagram, okay, this particular diagram. So this is what we need to discuss. In the next video we will talk about the pressure drop in the evaporator and the pressure drop in the condenser and how they affect the size of the condenser and the size of the evaporator, okay. So that is also a very important point that we need to discuss in the next video. Okay, thank you.